Hello and welcome to Paul and Lynn's Ride to Lake District, or the Lake District and Beyond, Part 7. This is Brough to Sedbergh. And we're just coming through Kirby Stephen on this A685. Nice little place, Kirby Stephen. And we just make a stop here for comfort break, or to spend a penny, whichever way you want to put it. But of course, we carry on. There we go. Yeah, it's a little lovely place. There's plenty of places to stop and have your tea, or if it's lunchtime, some lunch. Plenty of pubs. You can have a bar meal, cafes. You can have a cup of tea, hot chocolate, toasted tea cake, which is what we like. This is bad with that lorry parking. I mean, there's nowhere else to go, but makes it tricky for these traffic lights here. So yeah, so we're on the A685, and we're going to take a B road. I think it's a B. No. What am I saying? No, it's the A683. I think it is. To Sedbergh. Now, we've ridden this road before. We rode it with our friend Graham when we were on the K1600, and that particular day was a little bit drizzly, not much, very very fine, but I had the GoPro going that day, so I think I included the GoPro's footage rather than the contour footage, which is what you're watching now. So yeah, so that road, as I say, you've seen it before, but it's well worth seeing again. So I think at this stage there's an opportunity to say what we're thinking so far, both of us, of the FJR. Well, what can we say? It's wonderful, absolutely wonderful. Really is. The only thing I need to get for it, they're on the way, quite a long delivery time. I've ordered some Genmar spacers or bar risers for the bike, because I'm tall at 6 foot, long in the body, I'm tending to sort of, you know, lean quite down, if you will. So I've been spoiled with the K1600, there's no two ways about it. The riding position on that bike was near perfect. Probably thinking, well, what did you sell it for? Well, you know, for those who have been following the story, it's quite, you know, it's quite well known why. The main reason, top heavy, but the riding position, can't beat it. So I suppose we've been spoiled. The FJR has a comfort seat on, and it's one that's been sort of made by Tony Archer, I believe, who's based in Huddersfield, and we've had seats done for the Pan-European previously by Tony, and highly recommend the guy. You know, he's probably got 40 odd years experience in the business. He's based in Huddersfield, not far from the football ground, so it's well worth checking out if you're in the area. So right, so as I said, the comfort, you know, we've taken a step back, but the bike itself, I mean, I've done sort of probably 1600 miles now in just over a month, so I think that says it all, really. I'll have to stop it. I'd be wearing tyres out, you know, before we go on holiday. Don't want to do that. So, but addicted, absolutely addicted, and I'd rather be addicted to the motorcycle bug or drug than anything else. And it really is addictive. So, and as I speak on Friday the 3rd of June 2016, tomorrow, Saturday, I won't say her name, but a very good friend of ours is having her first motorcycle ride in her life. And yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I'm sure she is, as she put it, to quote her, what her daughters would come out with, well excited, you know, the modern way of talking. I've got a route in mind where to take her, and it's really exciting being able to do this, because it's on her bucket list. And to be able to tick it off on our bike is wonderful. I feel like privileged to be able to do that, and it's not the first time, you know. I've given rides to other people in the past, most notably a very, very good friend, John, is no longer with us, and he was in his late 80s when he went on the back of the Pan-European that we had at the time. So I think three times he came on our bike. He came on the Pan, and then I think he had two rides on the Goldwing, the Black Goldwing, and yeah, marvellous man. Miss him, I really do miss him. They don't make him like that now, they don't. So, anyway, we're headed for Sedba, as I said. When we get there, we park across from the Haddock Paddock, which is a fish and chip shop and cafe. We didn't eat in the cafe on this occasion, but we got some chips to eat outside. We parked the bike at the front there. It was lovely. We sat on a nice wooden bench, looking at the bike, eating a bag of chips, and well, after a full day's riding, does life get any better? I don't think so. No way. Right, so music time. Don't want to hear me yapping on all day. We'll see you on part 8. And part 8 is the final part. It's only a short one. It goes from Sedba to the M6. There's no point in putting the M6 motorway on. There's a video that shows our journey back from Cumbria down the M6. And you don't need to see that again. It's quite boring. Anyway, there we are. See you on part 8. Thanks for watching. Please comment, share, subscribe at Biker Paul, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.